In this Maya tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can make a wall shatter with a ball smashing into it using the bullet solver in Maya. Maya has many different physics simulation solvers, and it also has the bullet solver as well as ways that you can shatter an object in advance and then apply the solver to those pieces. To get started, we need to make a cube. You can click on the poly modeling shelf in Maya to create a cube. Then, if we click on the attribute editor, and if you don't see the attribute editor, click in the top right, this icon right here, and then we can click on PCube1. PCube1 is a little hard to understand, so if I come over here to my outliner, and again, if you don't see the outliner, you can just click outliner. I can press enter, and then label this wall. Then we notice that over here it says wall, wall shape, and then PolyCube1. This is part of the node history of Maya. But if we click on this first tab, wall, we can go ahead and scale it. We can scale in the X direction. We can say 90. And if you don't want it to go that way, we can press Control Z. And then we can scale in the Y direction, which will be up, let's say 10. And then we can scale in the Z direction, maybe 13. So now we have a wall, but notice it's below the grid. Here we can just go ahead and translate it half of the 10 by pressing 5. And then it snapped right on the grid. We also need to create a floor. So I'm going to go ahead and create a plane. Then I'll press R to scale it up, about this big. And then over here it says P-plane 1 in the outliner. I'm going to press Enter and label it ground. Now we're ready to get started with the bullet solver. Here I have the bullet tab, but you probably don't see this because you may not have the bullet plugin installed. To do that, go to Windows, Settings and Preferences, Plugin Manager. Go ahead and look for the bullet bundle right here, and then make sure you check Loaded and Auto Loaded. Once you do that, you should see the bullet plugin. If I click on Bullet Plugin, we get these options. But before we do anything with the bullet plugin, we need to make this wall shatter. So the first thing to do is click on the wall, and then instead of the modeling workspace, we want to move to the effects panel. That'll give us this field solvers and effects up at the top. If I click on effects, we notice that we have shatter. And anytime in Maya, when you see a little box, if you click on the box, you get extra options. So here we have the create shatter effect options in Maya. We have surface shatter, solid shatter, and crack shatter. For this, we're going to use solid shatter. And we want to have a lot more shards. So let's do 100 shards. Then we can change the seed value. This is just how it breaks up randomly. We want to have shapes. We can uncheck triangulate surface, and then we want to hide the original model. Then we just click create. It will give you an error this first time. That's okay. That's because we have to delete the history of this object. So if this happens to you, just go back to your object, click on the modeling workspace. Then on the poly modeling shelf, you'll see this icon right here, delete history. If you don't see that, you can always go to Edit, Delete by Type, History. Now, if I click Create, it can create the shatter effect because the history has been deleted. And here we can see the shatter effect. All these are now a collection of different objects that are shattered apart. But how do we make this actually crumble or even explode when we hit it with another ball? The first thing to do is now go to the bullet solver. While the wall is selected, I can create a bullet solver by clicking the three bowling pins. This will go ahead and create a collection that's bullet solved. And then if I press play, everything just explodes. So how do we stop everything from exploding when we press play? The first thing to do is click on the bullet solver 1. Then there's a couple different tabs, so we can see the bullet solver shape, then the solid shatter initial state, and the solid shatter set solve state. We want solid shatter 1 set initial state. And first, we want to have it initially sleeping. Then we want to change collision type to hull and reduce the margin to 0. Now it shouldn't explode. And as we can see, the object just sits there. So the next thing to do is to create something to collide with it. So I can go back to my poly modeling shelf in Maya and then create a sphere. I can press W on my keyboard to move the sphere. I'm going to move the sphere back. Then on the bullet shelf, I can go ahead and click Create Active Object. And if I press play, the ball falls to the ground and falls through the floor. So let's first fix it going through the floor, then we'll make it hit the wall. At the first frame, I'm going to go ahead and then click the ground. And instead of making an active object, I'm going to click this icon and create a passive rigid body object. So this is now a bullet rigid body object that's passive. We can also change this in the body type right here if you change your mind. So now let's go ahead and play. Now we see the ball hits the ground. But what we really want is the ball to smash into the wall. So let's go ahead and do that. If I click on the ball, then I can click on Rigid Body Shape 1. And for the initial velocity in the X direction, if I type negative 80 and then press play, notice that the ball smashes into the wall and then the wall crumbles. But it doesn't smash very hard and it doesn't even go through the wall. That's because the mass of the ball is only 1. If I change this mass to something like 75, it's going to smash through the wall more. So now it goes all the way through the wall and the wall explodes. But sometimes you may want to have actual control over the ball. So if you want to animate the ball, you can go back and then change this to a kinematic rigid body. So now it just stays put. It's still a rigid body, meaning it can impact things, but now we use the channel box editor to keyframe it. So I'll click on the channel box editor, and then on the first frame, so if I right-click on Translate X, key selected, then I move forward, say, to frame 100, and I move the ball forward, and then I right-click, key selected, I go back to frame 0, and I press play, the ball will move and into the actual object. This is a great feature if you need to have a certain animation happen with your ball that can't be easily made with physics. The downside of animating this way is you can see the ball stops right at the end, so you don't get that full physics action because we could put another passive collider in the background right here and have the ball bounce off it. So I'm going to go back to the beginning. I'll click on the ball, and on the attribute editor, I'm going to go back to dynamic rigid body. But I'm going to add another cube in the background for everything to hit into. So I'll click on Poly Modeling. I'll make a cube. I'll move it backwards. I'll move it up. I'll press R to scale. I'll scale it sideways. And then I'll also scale it up here. Press W. Move it up to right about here. And then on the bullet solver, I'll go ahead and make this a passive body as well. Now, if I press play, notice that everything reacts. Now, I could, of course, animate all of that, but the point of using a physics model is that I don't have to animate all those extra bounces of the ball and the bricks. So most of the time, you're going to want to use the bullet solver to solve everything and then create your animation based on its reactions to things in the world. But of course, we can always change that to a different type of rigid body, so that way we can animate it manually. Happy 3D modeling!